Hey guys, in this video I'm going to fix a problem in our parseURL module, send a GET request and then parse the response. The problem with parseURL is if we have a service which is not served on port AD or 443, our client fails that connection. For solve this issue, we have to change and write a few lines of code. Let's begin.
So, for solve this problem, we have to change a few lines here. So if v.contains a colon, so let's split split and v.split with colon. Let us, which is v dot, has split. This is to be mutable dot next dot unwrap. Let port, let's define port here. Let port, which is gonna be the size. Okay, so port equal hasplit dot next dot unwrap dot parse dot unwrap. Okay. If not contains colon, so we dot to string. And here has to string. This way. Oh, port is immutable. Okay, immutable. And let's add port here, pop port, which is new size, and port. So port is 80. Let's add for this, and after all, let's another test case, which is it's gonna be support, and let's run. Okay, this is it. Let's run all of this. So, oops, test one. Okay. What is the problem? Oh, we have to define this here. And here, if we is equal HTTPS, then port gonna be 443. Else port gonna be 80. And return B. Okay, skin. Oh, we got two string. So let's run all of them again. Test case 2. What is the problem for you? Mm-hmm. let's see, scheme HTTPS for test case 2. Why HTTPS? So why would this be HTTPS? This is HTTPS. Oh, this is gonna be 443. Okay. Okay, all of them pass, and for the next, let's parse our response abstract response, and our response gonna have a version, which is gonna be string, and I have a status code. And message. Oh no, status name is going to be a string, and headers, which is a hash map of string. Body, this is optional, and it is a vector of bytes. So let's implement response pub async fn new, gonna return the result of response and our error. Okay, so we want headers, gonna be mutable, and hash map. Gonna be none. Okay, let's mute response info, which is a string, and we need a loop, a match statement, and we need to get connection here. Have to be mutable, so match connection dot string dot read u8 read byte dot await. Okay, we have a byte here, and if we face the error, so it's end. And gonna break the loop. Okay, so first of all, oops, I forgot to define a buffer, which is a vector of bytes. And push byte. Okay, now we have few condition here. If our buffer, our byte as character does not equal to / n, then continue, go to next iteration. If match with / n, so if our response info is empty, so response info equal to string from UTF-8, and this is gonna be buffer, but we can't get all of the buffer because two bytes at the end of buffer is /r/n, which is carry return. So we have to exclude those. Okay, buffer until buffer.len -2, and this is gonna be vector, and what is the problem here? Oh, this is have to be, I think. Yeah. So what is the problem? Oh, it returns an error. So we have to add this error from UTF-8 error. So UTF-8 parsing error. Okay, let's copy this. Parsing response. So we have to implement from std string UTF-8 for our error type. So return error UTF-8 passing error. Okay. Error is gone. So for the next, we have to clear the buffer, and we need to define a variable here to let mutable is header section false. So we can use header section true. And if is header section, let's copy this. Let header line. So next, again we clear the buffer, and is header section gonna be false. Okay, next let's split the header line. So let header line split with colon. Okay, and let key equal match head return split dot next. If we have a value, it's we got to string dot trim. Oops, I need to use this here. And if we don't have a value, so return error, which is error, and we have to define another error, error parsing error. Okay, let's copy this in here one more time. Parsing headers of response. Okay, header parsing error. So let's copy this. It's gonna be value and result is same. Then headers up insert, okay, key and value. This is our header section, and we have a condition here. So for like this header section, we have to set this false to we can get the body. So if buffer dot len equal to, which is just backslash r backslash n, and buffer 0 index of this buffer, 0 first byte of this buffer as char equal to backslash r, so is header section false. Oops. And buffer dot clear and continue. Okay, we have all of this, and here we have to get version status code and status name from response info. Okay, let mute response info split. And this one, response info dot split will space. So let version match response info split dot next, of course, and value, if we have a value, so v dot to string, and if we don't, return error, error header parsing error. Okay, let's copy this. So this gonna be status code, which is unwrap, and status name, which is string. Okay, so here we can return our response. Okay, this is use size. Okay, we have to, okay, we have to define another condition here. If buffer dot len greater than 0, so body gonna be some buffer, so we can have the buffer body here. I'm sorry. So we have our response. Okay, Let's see connection. I think now, yes. So we gonna return a response here. Remove all of this and return response. New and need panic. Oops, gonna be safe, which is mutable. Borrowed mutable. Okay, what's the problem? Oh. So we have our head request here. So in the main, set yes, and we can printl and our response, but we can't. Why? Because it's not derived the debug. So derive debug. Okay, let's try this. So it's panicked. Where? Okay. Is this wrong? Subset will overflow. So what is the problem? It's okay, so this is the problem. Why is this a problem? So buffer until buffer dot length minus 2. Subset is overflow. Why is this overflow? So why is this a problem? Attempt to subtract will overflow. Buffer here. So buffer size is 0. What? Oh, this has to be like this. seconds. Okay. So what is the problem here? Push the byte to buffer. If byte not equal to backslash n, so continue. If is equal, we get here. If response info is empty, so response. Oh, so we have to. Continue here. This was the problem. Okay. That's it. But we have another problem here, I think. This is a head request. But we have a body here. So buffer not cleared. Why? So here we cleared buffer two, and we get here. We clear the buffer again. So why we have buffer? Wait a second. It's a head request. What is the problem? So let's print string from div 8 response body dot unwrap. Okay. So oh. This is a problem, I think. Get it right. This is the problem. Okay, okay. Into 2 at the given byte index. So we have to use this one for headers. Why? You can see this content. Okay, modified. Less modified is so. This is last modified. Where is date? Date. So you can see clearly that rest of the string is split because they have colon. So we have to split once. Okay, so this is gonna be str and str. key value. Let's result change this, but if we can have result that 0 1. Okay, so we can do match here. Return error and delete this in here. Running with this. So let's run it again. Okay, you can see this time date is completely parsed and last modified is complete. Okay, this is good thing. Body is none. Let's write the get request and let's see head request is gonna be get and we can add method later, but let's write in this way first. Okay, and if we listen to this one, IO error. Why? Oops, this is doesn't return enough header because of that. So let's send to this one. So as you can see, we have body here and we can print ln the body. This is gonna be Nginx return body and string from UTF-8 response.body.unwrap.unwrap. So if we run it again, that's it. This is body. So we covered a lot here today and let's end it here till the next video.